Today I'm gonna be diving into another fun Gazelle helicopter project. You'll be seeing a lot more of these types of videos coming out because each time I'm hanging out in my helicopter or with my buddies, we see something like, oh man, could you make this? Could you 3D print that? Could you scan this? And so almost each weekend, we're coming up with new ideas or seeing something that we'd like to make, improve upon, or just have some fun with. And so this is fun for me because it's functional and it helps my helicopter perform or look better. So the project we dove into this weekend was diving in to the lights that are on my buddy's helicopter. This light, you can barely see it when you're flying, and we're hanging out with buddies, us three, we're starting to fly in formation. And so these lights, Yasin has them on his, and you can see this guy from freaking miles away. So we want to retrofit ours and put some brighter LED lights that are much more visible. This is the Gazelle helicopter tail light, and his is very dim, like you can barely see it. My buddy Yasin, on the other hand, he took his old ones out and upgraded them to the Aveo lights. These things are expensive. They're like 6,000 bucks for the set, but man, can you see him? This, we're flying in the daytime, and if you notice, all three of our helicopters are camouflaged. So depending on where we're flying, it can be very hard to see your buddy. And sometimes we're moving around, or maybe we're chasing boats, or we're chasing off-road vehicles through the desert, and we're keeping comms on and we're talking to each other, but there's been times I'm like, I lose my buddy. I'm like, Jeffrey, where are you? Well, his helicopter against the mountain background is pretty much invisible. Yasin's, when we're chasing boats, his is blue, kind of like an ocean camo theme. So over the ocean, next thing you know, I lose him when we're chasing these offshore boats. I'm like, Yasin, where are you at? He's like, this light though, his lights I can see for freaking miles away. There was one time I was coming home, it was like probably midnight, I'm coming up the freeway and I look in the sky, and I'm not kidding you, I'm like, that's freaking Yasin right there. I could see his stuff blinking. It probably had to be 5, 6, 10 miles, and I could follow him, and I was like, oh, there he is. He's over his house right now, circling around for the kids. It was hilarious, but it adds so much safety. Because during the day, I don't know if you guys know, most aircraft accidents in the sky, the collisions happen in broad daylight, crystal clear, and they end up running into each other because sometimes they get camouflaged against the backdrop, the skyline and stuff like that. And so anything you can do to add visibility to help other people see and avoid you is a benefit in my book. So that's what Jeffrey wanted to do. We're starting to fly in formation. We're getting much closer. We're flying a lot of us all together. And so being able to keep sight and quickly see where people's at, it helps a lot. So these lights, I'll put up some footage and you can see, you can barely see them. They're on and they're flashing, but you can barely see it. And then I'll show you Yasin's when he has his on, how much brighter there are. So Yasin installed his, and when he put it in, he kind of retrofitted it, could have done a much better job because he used epoxy to put it into the tail section. Now it works, and he's at one screw holding it in. So, I mean, it serves its function and it'll probably be okay. It's not gonna fall out. But when Jeffrey went to put his in, he was gonna do the same. I said, no, let's do something. Let's make an adapter that'll be much more cleaner, much more pretty, and it'll function way better. And so what we did is we brought this in to 3D scan it. And I'm gonna show you guys a lot of things today. I'm gonna show you 3D scanning. I'm gonna show you guys some reverse engineering, some software that we use. We're gonna do 3D printing. We're gonna print in some pretty cool materials. All this stuff we sell on visionminer.com. If you see a process or you see something that I'm doing and you're like, hey, I would like to do that, or you're wondering, could it do this? Could I scan that? Could I print this? Give us a call. Just reach out to us. We're here to help. We're here to guide you. Even if we don't sell the products, we'll at least give you our best advice on what we would do in the similar situation. So you can check it out at visionminer.com. So anyways, we'll dive into it. The thing slides into the tail section like this, and it's round, but the new light is not round. So I need to match this shape up with this one and make it clean and beautiful. So I scanned this part. We could have probably taken a micrometer, calipers, and measured this, but I wasn't sure of the holes if they were clocked perfectly at 60 degrees. So rather than trying to measure and figure all that out, look, just throw it in a scan. You're gonna see how fast it is. We scan it, we take that data, and then we put it in an R&D, reverse engineer it. We create some planes, create some cylinders, and it makes it freaking perfect. So first we scan that part.
The free scan combo plus all its laser lines. We'll turn the table around and you see how fast it's capturing that data.
Nice.
Then we scanned this part. There's a rubber gasket there. So I took that off. This was kind of reflective. So we did some scanning spray on there. If you guys seen that stuff, it's awesome. You can spray it, it completely disappears in like 2 hours to 8 hours, depending on whether you use the blue spray or the orange spray.
All right, now we got the new light. So scan this real quick.
Then we'll have all that data. It's looking good.
We actually used some scanning spray to spray on there because this was a little bit reflective, but.
And then we were able to take both those scans, throw it in to some reverse engineering, create the planes and surfaces, and then we created our part.
Now we're going to reverse engineer it. And what we've done is we've gone in there and we create all the primitives, the planes, we can create cylinders, and then we can make it perfect exactly the way we want. And then we can cross-reference it right there. The green lets us know that everything within spec. So once we have that done, now we'll take that over into the CAD drawing and use this to make the final part.
Got something for you, Jeffrey.
All right, let's see it.
Yeah. So you gave us a tail light. I wasn't sure if these holes were like perfectly clocked at 60 and 60, so scanning it made sense. Sometimes you can just take micrometers and make the part, but scanning it gives us the perfect data so that we know exactly what we're reversing. So we took that, then Nazar scanned the new light, got the new light shape perfect, and then he designed the part to fit in. And then, all right, where's it at? Check it out. Oh, damn, look at
this. Nice, nice.
Look how perfect that is.
Wow, that is perfect.
So then I went to a CF nylon. I wanted to print in another better material that maybe I could use this and get a true fit. I was able to screw this into the helicopter to this end, make sure that it works, and that confirmed that we're a go. Now let's pick the material and do it in something functional and safe that works for this application. And so we went with CF peak. The CF peak is self-extinguishing. And so I had a little concern that being with electrical components, if this were to short out and cause a fire, if it was nylon, nylon would catch fire, it would continue to burn, and then it would start dripping hot flaming molten plastic onto the other parts, which could lead to other things. So just to be on the safe side, I went with this. Not only is it self-extinguishing, but it's low off-gassing. So a great material. The reason I started with PLA though is because this stuff is like $9 a roll and this stuff can get up to $800 a roll. So do all your prototyping in a lot cheaper material until you know for sure your part's perfect. And once you're good, then go ahead and go to your expensive stuff. So we printed this on the 22 IDEX V3. Took about a little less than an hour and it was completely done. And so we took this and now I can install it with these screws here. And I was actually really impressed with how well this went together. The it threads it nice and tight. I'm not worried about stripping it. This material, the CF Peak, Peak Ultim, have often been called metal replacements. And you can design and engineer parts to use these materials and replace a lot of parts that previously used to be metal. And so this is nice and snug and is ready to be installed. And it looks good. We've gone to this kind of old, outdated, to new and improved, ultra bright LEDs that we'll be able to see from miles away. To tell you a little bit more about this material and some really other awesome ones that may work for your application or that you may not have heard about, I'm gonna bring Rob in, because Rob is a master at these materials and their use cases. Rob, can you come and help me out?
Heck yeah, awesome. Dude, so like you were saying, you know, the self-extinguishing nature of PEEK is a big deal. It's kind of a good safety thing. But really, we're talking about aerospace grade materials, right? So there's this thing called the FST rating. That's flame smoke toxicity. And what aerospace guys are always looking for is the UL94 rating, specifically V0. There's V1, V2, V3. And it's all about the flame, the smoke, and the toxicity. So the self-extinguishing part is the flame. It will put itself out. The smoke part is the off-gassing, so how long it's going to smoke for before it stops, which is important, especially like inside airplane cabins and stuff like that. All the parts on your commercial jetliners are made with UL94 V-0 rated materials. Now we've got a couple other, the most popular is Ultim 9085, which a lot of the Stratasys guys will know. We've been printing this stuff for years. It's one of the easiest ones to print on these machines. And then of course, Ultim 1010, you've got PPSU and a few others that meet those certifications.
Awesome, thanks Rob, appreciate it.
You got it.
So now we're gonna take this, install it to the helicopter, and put it to use. And now we got it out of CF peak, and we slide this in. Oh, nice and snug, and the holes line up perfect. That looks good. I'm stoked. Good freaking work. All right, so we'll go get some nice stainless steel screws and go ahead and finish the install, wire it up, do a final test, then Jeffrey's gonna take it for a test flight. Woo-hoo! Let's go. We just finished avionics on mine, so we're gonna be able to test that, and then we're gonna test the final install of the lights. We got them all up and working. There's Jeffrey over there, the far one, my buddy Yasin. So I'm gonna jump in mine here, and I'll follow him and see how good those lights look. But right now, it's looking great. So let's go have some fun. Woo! Spooling up, man. Let's get this baby started up. Jeffrey's copter's all dialed in, and man, can you see a difference or what? That thing freaking lit up like a Christmas tree in the sky. And I thought I didn't need new ones on mine. I did a video, I'm like, oh, mine are pretty good. They got LEDs, but when you see them side by side, looks like we might be diving in and putting LEDs on this one too. So I think this was a great success. On mine, I need to scan that top light up there and 3D print an adapter for that. Then we'll use the same file of the back one. We'll get that done, and I'll just go ahead and put all of them back on and possibly might move that one down to the side right there. But might even have to add some to my little Taylor gun I did. But great success. I had an absolute blast doing this. We have a lot more projects coming out for the Gazelle. Things that we're gonna be scanning, custom floor mats, covers for the cyclic, plates cover up the wiring, custom mounts for the headrest, and then we're gonna get into some really exotic stuff of remounting the original rockets that came here. So we have this scanned, we'll be printing parts. So if you guys like any of this stuff, if you need any of this stuff, or you have questions like how can you do the scanning, if you've got a project you want questions on what scanner to get, what materials to print in, we got everything. SLS, SLA, we got our own 22 that does the high-temp printers. So hit us up, we're happy to guide you and make sure that you're choosing the right products even if we don't have it. And we will continue doing videos like this. I've been having a blast, having fun. So if you like it, hit that like, hit that subscribe, and we'll see you on the next video, guys. Thanks so much.